Hey everybody, SEIFERBOY here, and today's episode, or this week's series for the time being, is The Sims 2 for the Game Boy Advanced. So here I'm creating the channel's mascot, Seifer. So just going through the different options here. I don't know how long I've had this game, probably since at least 2005 or 6, I want to say. It's a fun game once you get into it though. And here's like a combination of the channel's neon green signature color and Seifer's black t-shirt. I thought that would be appropriate for him, and I chose intimidating because that's how the character is in the game he's in, or the games. He has at least two games he's in. One is Kingdom Hearts and the other is Final Fantasy VIII. So here we meet the guy running the whole TV studio. You're an actor, he hired to go out into the town and cause chaos. So here he's just explaining what your role is in Strange Town. I like how the door slides down. It makes it a hidden door. Here's our house we'll be staying in. Luckily, you don't have to pay any bills or anything, so that'll help you save money and be able to buy the better furniture and stuff, decor and stuff. And here we're meeting. Yeah, here's the name, Dusty Hog. He's a biker, as you can tell. And he lives in that trailer RV thing behind him. By the way, the town is within a desert, so I think that might be where The Sims 4 Strangerville gets its inspiration from. So here's Seifer trying to make friends with Dusty. It is pretty simple, but sometimes the characters make it more difficult for you because of their own personalities. Luckily, this one went smooth sailing. And you can get the romantic interactions later by unlocking them with the points you get at the end of each episode. There's, I think, 3 or maybe 4 seasons in the game altogether, and each season has their own episodes. And depending on how you do in each episode, that's how many points you receive at the end. And it's going to be the goth family who decides. Mortimer, Bella, Cassandra, and her little brother, I forgot his name though. I don't ever play with him on the games very often. So now we're going to the pawn shop, and here I'm picking up the recyclable things. There's the pawn shop with the pawn chess piece. By the way, if you hear anything in the background as background noise, it's probably my fan because it's pretty hot in my room at the moment. Those of you who lives in the UK without having central air conditioning will know how hot it can get. I don't live there, but other YouTubers I watch from England constantly complains about that, and that's something I have to deal with as well, so I'm in the same boat as all of you. And it's almost 90 degrees Fahrenheit. I think that's about 30 degrees Celsius, if I remember, around that number. If you haven't played the game yet, I think this part is gonna amuse you. I think it'll be amusing. Anyways, when you pick up the recyclables, you can take it to the scientist and exchange them for money. Here's our first alien. Boy, that's his name. I couldn't remember it. I know it was some weird thing. So you have to intimidate him and then he'll leave. But the toilet will be radioactive because it's not supposed to be green like that. Here I'm making sure I move to where you can see the alien as well instead of being in the way like when I first went into the bathroom. Luckily, this interaction was also easy to go through. Radiation squeegee. Daddy Bigbuck, so that's the guy's name, I guess. I wonder if he's in any other games. I don't remember, but the name sounds familiar. I'm pretty sure there's another Bigbuck's character in the game as well, so I think here's our first commercial to go through. This one is pretty fun. It's pretty much a soda monster chasing you as you're trying to escape with the drink. As you can see, there's 5 levels to the commercial games. I did pretty bad with this one. I kept stumbling and falling over the obstacles. I did better in future ones, though. Ah. By the way, I'm doing the voiceover after I play the game and record it. That way I can focus on the gameplay and do the commentary later. Otherwise, it's not as good, I don't think, as it could be. And as the saloon name hints, it's in the theme of an old town western, Wild Wild West saloon. There we go, our first bed. I was hoping I could rotate the shower, but apparently you're not able to, so I just had to place it way in the corner there. And then finally a couch. I chose green because it's the signature color of the channel, so I was happy with that one, plus it was the only one they had available in the pawn shop anyway, so wasn't much to choose from. I actually had to read back and figure out what to do with the recyclable things because I didn't remember, and I went through every screen I can think of to exchange them, but I wasn't able to figure it out until after the third episode when I read up on it. So there's that. That's the casino, and the saloon is behind there. That's the town hall. There's the rag and reel entrance. That's the other Daddy Bigbuck's character, or the other Bigbuck's, whatever. I forgot his name though. Hank Grant's the military guy. Era, she's really difficult to befriend though. I tried that in a future episode for the goals, but that took a little bit of time. High salt diet, that doesn't sound good. The Goth family. Did they show up in this one? I don't remember. I know for sure they did on the second episode. They're all sitting on a couch in front of a TV. I don't think it did at that time. They should have showed it though. I think I did buy the first one there, the pyramid one, the mystery. New set. I forgot what that one is for. Maybe for the house itself or something. I think I got a social move here. Maybe the second one, I want to say, if I remember.